Hey guys, it's Nino and Trace here with Tayo News.
We are here in downtown Los Angeles for a Sanghap, a Filipino food history experience.
Trace, it's about to be an experience for sure. We're about to go to all these booths and try the different Filipino foods. They're gonna tell us too what the influences are that make it Filipino food.
I am starving, so let's see what they got serving up.
Let's go.
Sanghap, which means ingredient in Tagalog, is a food festival in Los Angeles' historic El Pueblo district that explores Filipino-American history through a multicultural culinary experience.
Today's event is packed with a ton of food, art, entertainment, history, and we hope you all get a taste of all of it while you're here.
Chef John Eric Concordia, who owns Park's Finest Barbecue and Thunderbolt Bar, says foodies can appreciate Filipino food more by learning about its history at events like this one.
What's special about Sanghap is that the conversation about ingredients from Chinese, American, and Spanish by way of Mexico influence, that is what Filipino cuisine is in Los Angeles.
That mix of cultural influences is what makes the historic El Pueblo district so special, thanks to its location in downtown Los Angeles, a hub for LA's diverse communities.
That's one great thing about El Pueblo is that it's a multicultural site. All these cultures can come together, influence each other, have conversations, and new things can come out of that.
The festival brought folks in the community together for music, dancing, panels, and tons of amazing food.
All right, so we are here with Chef Issa to try out some of the food that she's prepared for the event. What do you got for us today? Like, what are you serving today?
So I've got a three-course menu for you guys to try.
Three courses, Trace? Let's
go. And we're gonna start with the first course.
Okay.
Which is my quinilao. It's wild Mexican shrimp with coconut vinegar. I've got some red onion, ginger, and I also have a touch of coconut milk, and then there's also the fresh calamansi you can squeeze on.
Oh, that is good.
There's the kick, I think. That's great.
And each of the featured chefs got to highlight a particular cultural aspect or ingredient to showcase within the dishes that they prepared for the attendees.
We're serving up some very traditional Filipino food, pork adobo. Very classic Filipino. I made it very basic. It's a lot of garlic, vinegar, soy sauce, black pepper, and bay leaf. There's a lot of variations on it, but this is like a core basic adobo.
This is the standard. This is
it's made with pork. Through the lens of Los Angeles' narrative, we have our lollipop drumettes, which conveys the Chinese influence with brown sugar and soy. And of course, a batangueño, totoong Tagalog style of cuisine, which also can be related to Mexicans' caldo del res, which is beef soup.
From what I've been able to tell is that our carnitas is very much like the lechon.
Yeah, it's like a sisig almost.
Yeah, basically. So the pork, from what I've learned, is a very main dish in both cultures. And then picadillo is like caldereta, which is like a stew. So the reason they invited me here is to show the linkages between old world, new world trade and what happened when they took our ingredients from Spain to Mexico, Philippines, and back, and how the mix happened.
After sampling a ton of savory deliciousness, it's time to satisfy our sweet tooths with a dessert. Topped off, of course, with a little bit of history.
So this is a crema de fruta.
This looks so good.
Basically, a lot of people have had fruit salad at every Filipino party growing up. This came from the idea of canned food that was brought to the Philippines before the turn of the 20th century. It was very much a luxury item. So this comes from that tradition.
Wow.
And it's just chilled. Okay.
Yeah, well, thank you so much.
Thank you. Peace out. I gotta go. Thank you.
It's such a beautiful thing because every place we've went to, there's been influences everywhere that we've been able to share, which creates our dishes that we see today. I definitely want to try this. Can we bite into it? Can we
check it out? Please, by all means.
Let's try
it first.
Let's do the lollipop.
Okay, yeah. So that's all for today. We got to try the four different restaurants and they were all so good. It was amazing to see Filipino food through different cultural lenses. And if you're in the LA area, definitely make sure to check them out.
Definitely such a great experience here. Thank you so much to Sanghap for having us here. Now for more videos just like this, you can catch our YouTube channel, follow us on Facebook and Instagram. It's just Tayo News, Instagram Tayo_news, but you can catch us on the daily newscast every week, Monday through Friday. My name is Nino.
And I'm Trace.
And we'll catch you guys next time.
See ya.